Hey friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Myself Neha, and name of my YouTube channel is Let's Talk About Accounting. Okay friends, now our today's video, a very important topic which almost each and every businessman performs, and that is the purchase of mobile. So if you purchase any mobile, then how you have to make that accounting entry in your Tally ERP9. Okay friends, so let's start with our accounting entry. So first of all, if you purchase a mobile, so if you're a proprietor, so basically, if you purchase a mobile, that will be definitely for office use. So you can easily bifurcate in your fixed asset. All right. So let's start with the accounting entry. First of all, go to accounting voucher. So if you are making a payment by bank, okay, by giving the check or by doing NEFT, or even in today's scenario, almost each and every person is doing either a Google Pay or either Paytm, okay, or even Phone Pay. So anyways, if you're performing any transaction by your bank, then automatically your bank will come into existence. Okay, so you have to make that entry by default in your payment voucher only. So let's go to your payment voucher, that is F5. Okay, so I have come in my payment voucher. You can see over here payment. Okay, so if I purchase it on a particular date, suppose 25th of May. Okay, so and I'm making the payment. I will repeat again that if you're making a payment by taking your bank, okay, any of the mode like NEFT, RTGS, even your by giving the check or your Google Pay or Paytm or Phone Pay, then your bank account will only get credited. Okay, so select your bank. Suppose my bank is ICICI Bank. Okay, there are two ways of making the entry. You can directly select the group as mobile. Okay, or if you're making a payment to a particular party, okay, then by double entry system we will pass our entry. Okay, suppose I'm making the payment to MM Communication. Okay, this is the party from whom I'm purchasing the mobile. Group it under sundry creditors, because we have to make payment, ultimately payment to that party, that is MM Communication. Okay, suppose I have purchased a particular mobile for ₹67,000 and I'm making the payment of 67,000. Okay, so I will enter the amount as 67,000 being payment made for mobile. Okay, so now as you have made the payment to that particular party, if you are making the entry by double entry system, then by default you have to make a second entry, and that is your mobile realization. Okay, then you have to select the voucher as journal. Okay, create the ledger as mobile. Okay, name it as, suppose you have purchased a Vivo mobile. Okay, Vivo, and you can also write any other name if you are having, okay, like Vivo, I don't know exactly, but Vivo F6. Okay, I will write it as, okay. Then it will come under fixed asset. Okay, I have purchased this mobile for 67,000 to MM Communication. Okay, being mobile realized. All right, so now let's see that how our transaction will be seen in our balance sheet. Go to your balance sheet. Under fixed asset, you would be able to see your mobile, okay, 67,000. Then again, we will go in balance sheet, we will go in current liabilities, then sundry creditors. Okay, we will select as F12. Okay, show opening balance, yes. Show transactions, yes. Why we are doing this exercise? Because when your creditors closing balance get closed, it automatically gets out of your sundry creditors, because only the outstanding list can be viewed in your sundry creditors and not that list for which the transaction is completed. As a transaction for MM Communication is completed, like how we have made a payment and we have also realized the expense, that why we have made that particular payment, so the closing balance is zero. If any of the amount has been outstanding, then ultimately it would have been seen in your sundry creditors list. All right, so for MM Communication, first we made the payment. And second entry we have passed as double entry system. Why? Because we have to realize the expense, and the expense was mobile purchased. All right. So many of my students, what they are making the mistake, that the mobile has been purchased, Okay, so we will make that entry in purchase ledger. No, not at all. Mobile is your fixed asset, and always you have to make that entry, or you have to realize the mobile under journal voucher only. All right, friends, I hope this concept must be cleared, that how you have to make a mobile purchase entry in your Tally ERP 9. All right, so do subscribe my YouTube channel. Keep supporting. Thank you.